Hi, welcome to another tutorial of Annotation series. My name is Jayraj and thanks for joining again. So in this tutorial we will learn qualifier annotation. So in previous tutorial we have seen autovire annotation, and if you haven't watched that, please go back and watch that first, and link is in the description. So this annotation is the extension of autovire, and we normally use this annotation with the combination of autovire. But why we need this and what problem it solves? So as the name suggests, it does the work of qualifier. So this is the signature of annotation in the spring. And as you can see here, it has one element required, which is a string value. And as I mentioned that all annotations have two basic properties, a target and a retention. So for this annotation, target is a field, method, parameter, annotation type. So you can use this annotation with these elements of Java. And retention policy for this annotation is runtime, and meaning of that is this annotation will go till runtime. And if we think logically, this annotation works with the combination of autovire annotation, and which also has the retention policy of runtime, because dependency injection takes place at runtime. So use of this annotation is to make a field or parameter qualify as a candidate beans for autowiring. And I hope you guys know the concept of dependency injection and autowire, and this annotation will help to reduce the ambiguity over there. So thing is, when Spring containers scan our project at the time of application startup and start creating all the necessary beans and start doing this dependency injection, and container will look for all dependent beans and objects for that, and Spring resolves dependency by type by default. But let's say if container founds more than one object available for same type, then it gets confused about which one to inject. So take our previous example of car, and we have one interface called engine, and which was implemented by class economies. So we have one economy engine and we have one car class, and this car needs an engine. So in this case, car is dependent on engine, and when we create car, this economy engine will be injected. But imagine we have two engines. We have economy engine and we have sport engine. So when Spring containers start our application, and at the time of dependency injection, it founds two engines. Now we have sport engine and we have economy engine. So engine will get confused because we have multiple engines of the same time, and now what to inject. So in this case, we can use this qualifier annotation to resolve this ambiguity. So in our class, we can do something like this. And here we are passing this economy engine, and this time when we create this car, only economy engine will be added here. So this economy here is a default name, and if we want, we can change this. But everything happens at the runtime, and that's why the retention policy. So this string element inside the annotation holds the name of the qualifier being. And the benefit of using this annotation is to reduce ambiguity at the time of dependency injection. So that was Spring annotation qualifier, and that's all for now, and see you in next tutorial. Till then, like, share and subscribe. Thank you very much.